This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The World Bank Group WBG is a family of five international organizations that make leveraged loans to developing countries. It is the largest and most famous development bank in the world and is an observer at the United Nations Development Group. The bank is based in Washington, D.C. and provided around $61 billion in loans and assistance to developing and transition countries in the 2014 fiscal year. The bank's stated mission is to achieve the twin goals of ending extreme poverty and building shared prosperity. Its five organizations are the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development (IBRD), the International Development Association (IDA), the International Finance Corporation (IFC), the Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency (MIGA) and the International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes (ICSID). The World Bank's, the IBRD and IDA's activities are focused on developing countries, in fields such as human development e.g. education, health, agriculture and rural development e.g. irrigation and rural services, environmental protection e.g. pollution reduction, establishing and enforcing regulations, infrastructure e.g. roads, urban regeneration, and electricity, large industrial construction projects, and governance e.g. anti-corruption, legal institutions development. The IBRD and IDA provide loans at preferential rates to member countries, as well as grants to the poorest countries. Loans or grants for specific projects are often linked to wider policy changes in the sector or the country's economy as a whole. For example, a loan to improve coastal environmental management may be linked to development of new environmental institutions at national and local levels and the implementation of new regulations to limit pollution, or not, such as in the World Bank financed constructions of paper mills along the Rio Uruguay in 2006. The World Bank has received various criticisms over the years and was tarnished by a scandal with the bank's then president Paul Wolfowitz and his aide, Shaha Riza, in 2007. Contents 1 History 11 Founding 2 Membership 3 Organizational Structure 31 World Bank Group Agencies 32 Presidency 321 Current President 33 Independent Evaluation Group 34 Extractive Industries Review 35 Impact Evaluations 36 Access to Information 4 Criticism 41 AIDS Funding 42 Allegations of Corruption 43 Investments 5 List of Presidents 6 List of Chief Economists 7 List of World Bank Directors General of Evaluation 8 List of World Bank Board of Directors 9 References 10 External Links History Founding. The WBG came into formal existence on 27 December 1945 following international ratification of the Bretton Woods Agreements, which emerged from the United Nations Monetary and Financial Conference 1-22 July 1944. It also provided the foundation of the Oceander Committee in 1951, responsible for the preparation and evaluation of the World Development Report commencing operations on 25 June 1946. It approved its first loan on 9 May 1947, US$250 million to France for post-war reconstruction, in real terms the largest loan issued by the bank to date. Membership World Bank Group. Djibouti, Bahrain, Qatar, Iran, Malta, Bulgaria, Poland, Russia, Belarus, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Thailand, Laos, Vietnam, Palau, Tonga, Vanuatu, Maldives, Bhutan, Myanmar. All 5 WBG organizations, the rest of the 138 WBG members. Non-members are, Andorra, Cuba, Liechtenstein, Monaco, State of Palestine, Vatican City, Taiwan and North Korea. Organizational structure. The World Bank Group Building in Washington, D.C. The World Bank sign on the building together with 4 affiliated agencies created between 1957 and 1988. The IBRD is part of the World Bank Group. The group's headquarters are in Washington, D.C. It is an international organization owned by member governments. Although it makes profits, these profits are used to support continued efforts in poverty reduction. Technically, the World Bank is part of the United Nations system, but its governance structure is different. Each institution in the World Bank Group is owned by its member governments, which subscribe to its basic share capital, with votes proportional to shareholding. Membership gives certain voting rights that are the same for all countries, but there are also additional votes which depend on financial contributions to the organization. The President of the World Bank is nominated by the President of the United States and elected by the bank's Board of Governors as of 15 November 2009. The United States held 164% of total votes, Japan 79%, Germany 45%, the United Kingdom 43%, and France 43%. As changes to the bank's charter require an 85% supermajority, the U.S. can block any major change in the bank's governing structure. World Bank Group agencies. The World Bank Group consists of the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development (IBRD), established in 1945, which provides debt financing on the basis of sovereign guarantees, the International Finance Corporation (IFC), established in 1956, which provides various forms of financing without sovereign guarantees, primarily to the private sector, the International Development Association (IDA), established in 1960, which provides concessional financing interest-free loans or grants, usually with sovereign guarantees, the International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes ICSID, established in 1965, which works with governments to reduce investment risk, the Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency MIGA, established in 1988, which provides insurance against certain types of risk, including political risk, primarily to the private sector. The term World Bank generally refers to just the IBRD and IDA, whereas the term World Bank Group or WBG is used to refer to all five institutions collectively. The World Bank Institute is the capacity development branch of the World Bank, providing learning and other capacity building programs to member countries. The IBRD has 189 member governments, and the other institutions have between 153 and 184 members. The institutions of the World Bank Group are all run by a Board of Governors meeting once a year. Each member country appoints a governor, generally its Minister of Finance, on a daily basis. The World Bank Group is run by a board of 25 executive directors to whom the governors have delegated certain powers. Each director represents either one country for the largest countries, or a group of countries. Executive directors are appointed by their respective governments or the constituencies. The agencies of the World Bank are each governed by their articles of agreement that serve as the legal and institutional foundation for all of their work. The activities of the IFC and MIGA include investment in the private sector and providing insurance, respectively. Presidency. Traditionally, the bank president has always been a U.S. citizen nominated by the President of the United States, the largest shareholder in the bank. The nominee is subject to confirmation by the Board of Governors, to serve for a five-year, renewable term. Current President. On 30 May 2007, U.S. President George W. Bush nominated former Deputy Secretary of State Robert Zoellick to succeed Paul Wolfowitz as President of the World Bank Group. The executive directors unanimously approved Zoellick, effective 1 July 2007, as the 11th President of the bank for a five-year term. Robert Zoellick is the former Deputy Secretary of the U.S. State Department and the former Chairman of Goldman Sachs Board of International Advisors. He graduated magna cum laude from Harvard Law School and Harvard Kennedy School and Phi Beta Kappa from Swarthmore College. Zoellick announced in October 2007 that his priorities for the World Bank included increasing efforts to reduce poverty in the world's poorest countries, increasing support for neglected Arab countries, increasing support for countries emerging from violent conflicts, addressing poverty in emerging economies like India and China, increasing emphasis on environmental issues, especially global warming, and improving access to treatments for HIV and malaria. During this same period, the bank's failure to adequately consider social environmental factors was most evident in the 1976 Indonesian transmigration program, Transmigration V. This project was funded after the establishment of the bank's OESA Environmental Office in 1971. According to the bank critic Le Prester, Transmigration V was the largest resettlement program ever attempted, designed ultimately to transfer, over a period of 20 years, 65 million of the nation's 165 million inhabitants from the overcrowded islands of Java, Bali, Madura, and Lombok. 175. The objectives were relief of the economic and social problems of the inner islands, reduction of unemployment on Java, relocation of manpower to the outer islands, and to strengthen national unity through ethnic integration, and improve the living standard of the poor. Le Prester 175. Putting aside the political aspects of such a project, it otherwise failed as the new settlements went out of control, local populations fought with the migrators and the tropical forest was devastated, destroying the lives of indigenous peoples also. OME settlements were established in inhospitable sites, and failures were common. These concerns were noted by the bank's environmental unit, whose recommendations to bank management and analyses were ignored. Le Prester 176 funding continued through 1987, despite the problems noted and despite the bank's published stipulations 1982 concerning the treatment of groups to be resettled. More recent authors have pointed out that the World Bank learned from the mistakes of projects such as Transmigration V and greatly improved its social and environmental controls, especially during the 1990s. It has established a set of safeguard policies that set out wide-ranging basic criteria that projects must meet to be acceptable. The policies are demanding, and as Malaby reference below observes, because of the combined pressures from northern NGOs and shareholders, the bank's project managers labor under safeguard rules covering 10 sensitives issues. No other development lender is hamstrung in this way. Page 389. The 10 policies cover environmental assessment, natural habitats, forests, pest management, cultural property, involuntary resettlement, indigenous peoples, safety of dams, disputed areas, and international waterways. On the 16 April 2012, President Barack Obama announced that Jim Yong Kim would be the next president of the World Bank Group. Kim assumed office on 1 July 2012. Independent Evaluation Group. The Independent Evaluation Group IEG, formerly known as the Operations Evaluation Department OED, plays an important check and balance role in the World Bank. Similar in its role to the U.S. government's Government Accountability Office GAO, it is an independent unit of the World Bank that reports evaluation findings directly to the bank's board of executive directors. Caroline Hyder is the director general, evaluation, whose evaluations provide an objective basis for assessing the results of the bank's work and ensuring accountability of World Bank management to the member countries through the World Bank board in the achievement of its objectives. Extractive Industries Review. After long-standing criticisms from civil society of the bank's involvement in the oil, gas, and mining sectors, the World Bank in July 2001 launched an independent review called the Extractive Industries Review IR, not to be confused with Environmental Impact Report. The review was headed by an eminent person, Dr. Emil Salim, former Environment Minister of Indonesia. Dr. Salim held consultations with a wide range of stakeholders in 2002 and 2003. The IR recommendations were published in January 2004 in a final report entitled Striking a Better Balance. The report concluded that fossil fuel and mining projects do not alleviate poverty, and recommended that World Bank involvement with these sectors be phased out by 2008 to be replaced by investment in renewable energy and clean energy. The World Bank published its management response to the IR in September 2004 following extensive discussions with the board of directors. The management response did not accept many of the IR report's conclusions. However, the IR served to alter the World Bank's policies on oil, gas, and mining in important ways, as has been documented by the World Bank in a recent follow-up report. One area of particular controversy concerned the rights of indigenous peoples. Critics point out that the management response weakened a key recommendation that indigenous peoples and affected communities should have to provide consent for projects to proceed. Instead, there would be consultation following the IR process. The World Bank issued a revised policy on indigenous peoples' impact evaluations. In recent years, there has been an increased focus on measuring results of World Bank development assistance through impact evaluations. An impact evaluation assesses the changes in the well-being of individuals that can be attributed to a particular project, program, or policy. Impact evaluations demand a substantial amount of information, time, and resources. Therefore, it is important to select carefully the public actions that will be evaluated. One of the important considerations that could govern the selection of interventions, whether they be projects, programs, or policies for impact evaluation, is the potential of evaluation results for learning in general. It is best to evaluate interventions that maximize the possibility of learning from current poverty reduction efforts and provide insights for mid-course correction, as necessary. Access to information. The World Bank Policy on Access to Information sets forth a groundbreaking change in how the World Bank makes information available to the public. Now the public can get more information than ever before. Information about projects under preparation, projects under implementation, analytic and advisory activities, and board proceedings over the past 15 years. The World Bank's policy on disclosing information has evolved gradually until now. The World Bank's approach has been to spell out what documents the World Bank discloses. The new World Bank policy on access to information effective 1 July 2010 is a pivotal shift in the World Bank's approach to making information available to the public under the new policy. The World Bank will disclose any information in its possession that is not on a list of exceptions. This policy positions the World Bank as a leader in transparency and accountability among international institutions. Criticism: a young World Bank protester in Jakarta, Indonesia. World Bank, IMF protesters smashed the windows of this PNC Bank branch located in the Logan Circle neighborhood of Washington, D.C. The World Bank has long been criticized by a range of non-governmental organizations and academics, notably including its former chief economist Joseph Stiglitz, who is equally critical of the International Monetary Fund, the U.S. Treasury Department, and U.S. and other developed country trade negotiators. Critics argue that the so-called free market reform policies, which the bank advocates in many cases, in practice are often harmful to economic development if implemented badly, too quickly, shock therapy, in the wrong sequence, or in very weak, incompetitive economies. World Bank loan agreements can also force procurements of goods and services at incompetitive, non-free market prices. 5. In Masters of Illusion, The World Bank and the Poverty of Nations, 1996, Catherine Cofield argues that the assumptions and structure of the World Bank operation ultimately harms developing nations rather than promoting them in terms of assumption. Cofield first criticizes the highly homogenized and Western recipes of development held by the bank to the World Bank. Different nations and regions are indistinguishable, and ready to receive the uniform remedy of development. The danger of this assumption is that to attain even small portions of success, Western approaches to life are adopted and traditional economic structures and values are abandoned. A second assumption is that poor countries cannot modernize without money and advice from abroad. A number of intellectuals in developing countries have argued that the World Bank is deeply implicated in contemporary modes of donor and NGO-driven imperialism, and that its intellectual contribution functions, primarily, to seek to blame the poor for their condition. Defenders of the World Bank contend that no country is forced to borrow its money. The bank provides both loans and grants. Even the loans are concessional, since they are given to countries that have no access to international capital markets. Furthermore, the loans, both to poor and middle-income countries, are at below-market value interest rates. The World Bank argues that it can help development more through loans than grants, because money repaid on the loans can then be lent for other projects. Criticism was also expressed towards the IFC and MIGA and their way of evaluating the social and environmental impact of their projects. Critics state that even though IFC and MIGA have more of these standards than the World Bank, they mostly rely on private sector clients to monitor their implementation and miss an independent monitoring institution in this context. This is why an extensive review of the institution's implementation strategy of social and environmental standards is demanded. AIDS funding. The World Bank is a major source of funding for combating AIDS in poor countries. In the past 6 years, it has committed about $2 billion through grants, loans and credits for programs to fight HIV, AIDS. Allegations of corruption. The World Bank's Integrity Vice Presidency, INT, is charged with investigation of internal fraud and corruption, including complaint intake, investigation and investigation reports. Investments. The World Bank Group has also been criticized for investing in projects with human rights issues. The compliance advisor, Ombudsman Sao, criticized a loan given to the palm oil company Danone by the World Bank after the 2009 Honduran coup d'etat. There have been numerous killings of peasants in the region where Danone was operating. Other controversial investments include loans for the Chizoy hydroelectric dam in Guatemala while it was under military dictatorship, and a loan to Goldcorp then Glamis Gold for the construction of the Marlin Mine. List of presidents. Eugene Meyer, the 18th of June 1946 to the 4th of December 1946. John J. McCloy, the 17th of March 1947 to the 1st of July 1949. Eugene R. Black Sr., the 1st of July 1949 to the 1st of January 1963. George D. Woods 1, January 1963 to 1 April 1968 Robert McNamara 1 April 1968 to 1 July 1981 Alden W. Clausen 1 July 1981 to 1 July 1986 Barber Conable 1 July 1986 to 1 September 1991 Louis T. Preston 1 September 1991 to 1 February 1995 Acting, Ernest Stern 1 February 1995 to 1 June 1995 James Wolfenson 1 June 1995 to 1 June 2005 Paul Wolfowitz 1 June 2005 to 1 July 2007 Robert Zolik 1 July 2007 to 1 July 2012 Jim Yong Kim 1 July 2012 Present list of chief economists. Main article, World Bank Chief Economist Hollis B. Chenery 1972-1982 Ann Osborne Kruger 1982-1986 Stanley Fisher 1988-1990 Lawrence Summers 1991-1993 Michael Bruno 1993-1996 Joseph E. Stiglitz 1997-2000 Nicholas Stern 2000-2003 François Bourguignon 2003-2007 Justin Yifu Lin June 2008-June 2012 Martin Revalian, June 2012-October 2012 Kaushik Basu October 2012-July 2016 Paul Romer August 2016 List of World Bank Directors General of Evaluation Main Article, World Bank Director General Evaluation Christopher Willoughby, successively Unit Chief, Division Chief, and Department Director for Operations Evaluation 1970-1976 Mervyn L. Wiener, First Director General, Operations Evaluation 1975-1984. Yves Rovani, Director General, Operations Evaluation 1986-1992 Robert Pachotto, Director General, Operations Evaluation 1992-2002 Gregory K. Ingram, Director General, Operations Evaluation 2002-2005 Vinod Thomas, Director General, Evaluation 2005-2011 Caroline Hyder, Director General, Evaluation 2011 Present list of World Bank Board of Directors Sarah Avial, United States Alistair Smith, Canada, Ireland, Guyana, Jamaica, Bahamas, Antigua and Barbuda, Belize, Barbados, Dominica, Grenada, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia, and St. Vincent and the Grenadines Juan José Bravo Moises, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, Mexico, Nicaragua, Spain, Venezuela Roberto Tan, Philippines, Colombia, Ecuador, Haiti, Dominican Republic, Suriname, Brazil César Guido Forcheri, Argentina, Chile, Peru, Bolivia, Paraguay, Uruguay Satu Santala, Iceland, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Denmark, Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania Gwen Hines, United Kingdom Ingrid Hoven, Germany. Hervé de Villaroche, France Gino Alzetta, Belgium, Luxembourg, Czech Republic, Austria, Slovak Republic, Hungary, Kosovo, Belarus, Turkey Frank Heemskerk, Netherlands, Croatia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Ukraine, Moldova, Romania, Montenegro, Macedonia, Bulgaria, Georgia, Armenia, Israel, Cyprus Piero Cipollone, Albania, Greece, Italy, Malta, Portugal, San Marino, Timor-Leste Omar Bougoura, Algeria, Afghanistan, Ghana Islamic Republic of Iran, Morocco, Pakistan, Tunisia Agapito Mendes Dias, Benin, Burkina Faso, Cameroon, Cape Verde, Central African Republic, Chad, Comoros, Democratic Republic of Congo, Republic of Congo, Côte d'Ivoire, Djibouti, Equatorial Guinea, Gabon, Guinea, Guinea-Bissau, Madagascar, Mali, Mauritius, Niger, São Tomé and Príncipe, Senegal, Togo Deni H. Kalyalia, Botswana, Burundi, Eritrea, Ethiopia, the Gambia, Kenya, Lesotho, Liberia, Malawi, Mozambique, Namibia, Rwanda, Seychelles, Sierra Leone, Somalia, South Sudan, Sudan, Swaziland, Tanzania, Uganda, Zambia, and Zimbabwe Mansur Mutter, Angola, Nigeria, South Africa Mirza Hassan, Bahrain, Arab Republic of Egypt, Jordan, Iraq, Kuwait, Lebanon, Libya, Maldives, Oman, Qatar, United Arab Emirates, and Republic of Yemen. Jorg Frieden, Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyz Republic, Poland, Serbia, Switzerland, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. Andrei Lushin, Russian Federation, Syrian Arab Republic. Shikshan Chen, China. Mukesh Nandan Prasad, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, and Sri Lanka. Sundaran Annamalai, Brunei Darussalam, Fiji, Indonesia, Lao People's Democratic Republic, Malaysia, Myanmar, Nepal, Singapore, Thailand, Tonga, and Vietnam. Michael Wilcock, Australia, Cambodia, Kiribati, South Korea, Marshall Islands, Micronesia, Mongolia, New Zealand, Palau, Papua New Guinea, Samoa, Solomon Islands, Tuvalu and Vanuatu. Hideaki Suzuki, Japan. Saudi Arabia's seat is currently vacant. References carat http://worldbankorg/and/about. Carat Board of Directors WebWorldBankorg retrieved 31 May 2010. As President of the World Bank, press release, World Bankorg, 25 June 2007, accessed 12 July 2007 corrected date carat Office of the President Biography WebWorldBankorg retrieved 31 May 2010. November 2004, accessed 30 May 2007 carat World Bank Operational Manual, Operational Policies, Indigenous Peoples Opus 410, World Bankorg, July 2005, accessed 30 May 2007 carat Access to Information World Bankorg retrieved 27 May 2012. Carat ABC Michaleko, Cyril Beyond Reform, It's Time to Shut Down the World Bank Upside Down World retrieved 5 April 2014. Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes Presidents Eugene Meyer John J. McCloy Eugene R. Black Sr. George David Woods Robert McNamara Alden W. Clausen Barber Connable Lewis Thompson Preston James Wolfenson Paul Wolfowitz Robert Zolik Jim Yong Kim Elections 1946-1947 1949-1963-1968-1981-1986-1991-1995-2005-2007-2012 VE Central Banks. Financial Stability Board. Central Bank of the Gambia Bank of Ghana Central Bank of the Republic of Guinea Central Bank of Kenya Central Bank of Lesotho Central Bank of Liberia Central Bank of Libya Central Bank of Madagascar Reserve Bank of Malawi Central Bank of Mauritania Bank of Mauritius Bank Al-Maghrib Morocco Bank of Mozambique Bank of Namibia Central Bank of Nigeria National Bank of Rwanda Central Bank of Sao Tome and Principe Central Bank of Seychelles Bank of Sierra Leone Central Bank of Somalia Bank of Somaliland South African Reserve Bank Bank of South Sudan Central Bank of Sudan Central Bank of Swaziland Bank of Tanzania Central Bank of Tunisia Bank of Uganda Bank of Zambia Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe Americas Central Bank of Argentina Central Bank of Aruba Central Bank of the Bahamas Central Bank of Barbados Bermuda Monetary Authority Central Bank of Brazil Bank of Canada Central Bank of Chile Bank of the Republic Colombia Central Bank of Cuba Central Bank of Curaçao and Sint Maarten Eastern Caribbean Central Bank Cayman Islands Monetary Authority Central Bank of Ecuador Bank of Guatemala Bank of the Republic of Haiti Central Bank of Honduras Bank of Jamaica Bank of Mexico Central Bank of Nicaragua Central Reserve Bank of Peru Central Bank of Suriname Central Bank of Trinidad and Tobago Federal Reserve System United States Central Bank of the Uruguay Central Bank of Venezuela Asia DA Afghanistan Bank Central Bank of Bahrain Bangladesh Bank Royal Monetary Authority of Bhutan Brunei Currency and Monetary Board Autorité Monetary Brunei Darussalam National Bank of Cambodia People's Bank of China Hong Kong Monetary Authority Reserve Bank of India Bank Indonesia Central Bank of the Islamic Republic of Iran Central Bank of Iraq Bank of Israel Bank of Japan Central Bank of Jordan National Bank of Kazakhstan National Bank of the Kyrgyz Republic Bank of Korea Central Bank of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea Central Bank of Kuwait Bank du Liban Monetary Authority of Macau Bank Negara Malaysia Maldives Monetary Authority Bank of Mongolia Central Bank of Myanmar Nepal Rastra Bank Central Bank of Oman State Bank of Pakistan Palestine Monetary Authority Banco Central ng Pilipinas Qatar Central Bank Saudi Arabian Monetary Agency Monetary Authority of Singapore Central Bank of Sri Lanka Central Bank of Syria Central Bank of the Republic of China Taiwan Bank of Thailand Central Bank of Turkmenistan Central Bank of the United Arab Emirates Central Bank of Uzbekistan State Bank of Vietnam Central Bank of Yemen Europe European Central Bank Eurosystem National Bank of the Republic of Abkhazia Bank of Albania Central Bank of Armenia National Bank of Austria Central Bank of Azerbaijan, National Bank of the Republic of Belarus, National Bank of Belgium, Central Bank of Bosnia and Herzegovina, Bulgarian National Bank, Croatian National Bank, Central Bank of Cyprus, Czech National Bank, Denmark's National Bank, Denmark, Deutsche Bundesbank, Germany, Bank of England, Bank of Estonia, Bank of Finland, Bank de France, National Bank of Georgia, Bank of Greece, Hungarian National Bank, Central Bank of Iceland, Central Bank of Ireland, Banca d'Italia, Central Bank of Kosovo, Bank of Latvia, Bank of Lithuania, Central Bank of Luxembourg, National Bank of the Republic of Macedonia, Central Bank of Malta, National Bank of Moldova, Central Bank of Montenegro, De Nederlandse Bank, Norges Bank, Central Bank of the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus, National Bank of Poland, Banco de Portugal, National Bank of Romania, Central Bank of Russia, National Bank of Serbia, National Bank of Slovakia, Bank of Slovenia, Gosbank, Soviet Union, Bank of Spain, Swedish National Bank, Swiss National Bank, Central Bank of the Republic of Turkey, National Bank of Ukraine, Oceania, Reserve Bank of Australia, Reserve Bank of Fiji, Reserve Bank of New Zealand, Bank of Papua New Guinea, Central Bank of Samoa, Central Bank of Solomon Islands, National Reserve Bank of Tonga, Reserve Bank of Vanuatu, Bretton Woods System, International Monetary Fund, World Bank Group, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes, International Development Association, International Finance Corporation, Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency Limited Recognition, VE, International Organizations, Intergovernmental Organizations, Non-Cultural IGOs, International Criminal Court, International Monetary Fund, International Seabed Authority, Interparliamentary Union, Interpol, New Development Bank, Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, United Nations, World Bank Group, World Trade Organization, Cultural IGOs.